Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the NData Project at Easter Seals Crossroads, and today we're going to be taking a look at Code Jumper, which is a unique system to allow everybody, no matter what your ability is, to enjoy coding on the computer. And so let's go ahead and take a look.
Hi, I'm Dave Wilkinson. I'm the Director of Sales at the American Printing House for the Blind in Louisville, Kentucky. And we are at the ATIA conference where we are giving the debut of Code Jumper. And Code Jumper is a physical way of teaching programming to blind children or children with low vision, ages 7 through 11. And what it does is it takes coding and turns it into physical pieces and allows you to build stories, whether they be songs, soundscapes, poems, etc. And as you're creating these stories, you're learning how to code. So it'll probably make a little bit more sense as we turn around and actually show Code Jumper. It is running on a Microsoft Surface. It currently has an app in the Microsoft Store. It works on Windows 10 devices. We will in the future be developing apps for Android and iOS, so stay tuned. And this is a good time to point out that you can always stay tuned with the latest happenings with Code Jumper by going to our website, codejumper.com. And there you can sign up for our mailing list. You can get onto our waiting list so that you'll know when the product is available, which should be sometime in late July. So let's play with Code Jumper. Code Jumper works off of a hub and a series of different types of pods. The hub is connected. I know, it's all that plus more. I always assume the applause is for me. The pods are different types of pods. I'm holding in my hand a loop pod, which is a different color from our action play pods, which are different colors from, we have pods for if-then statements. We're reaching into our Code Jumper case here that we're just pulling out different pods. We're gonna do a very basic construction of a song, and we'll see where it goes. So you know that Code Jumper is working when you load the app. You'll hear a little click to let you know that the hub is working. And now we're going to plug in our first play pod, and we heard our click, and the top knob controls the pitch. So we don't actually want any merrily at this point. We're going to go for row for the beginning of row, row, row your boat.
Merrily, 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 row.
So here we go, we have row, and as is the case with a lot of coding, there's multiple ways of doing things. So I could plug in a second pod, and we'll make it say row as well.
Gently, gently, life is
so now we have two rows, and I can hit my play button to hear how the code is going so far.
Row, row.
Now I know you out there are thinking this isn't the most efficient way of doing this. Bear with me, and we'll show you how to make a loop in a little bit. And we're going to make one more row. And before we will make it say row, row, row your boat.
Merrily,
oops. User error.
Merrily, merrily, life is gently down your boat.
So now we have it singing row, row, row your boat.
Row, row, row your boat.
And I could keep going for gently down the stream and to make the rest of the song. But what I want to show you how to do is it's not really efficient to have three pods going row, 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 right? So we can learn the concept of using a loop. And so now we're going to pick up our loop pod, and you'll notice that one cable is longer than the other. The shorter cable is going to go into the beginning of where the loop should be, which is right out of the hub. And now we're going to actually physically create a loop. And to do that, we're going to take the first pod, and we're going to see if we have this done correctly, which we may or may not.
4, 3.
And let's see if we have it correctly.
Row, row, row.
awesome. So I got the loop right for row, 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 and now I can take a second pod and have your boat, and it's going to be a much more efficient loop. So we're going to plug our pod in.
Your boat. Boat.
And I am a coding genius. And each of these pods just represents a separate line of code. And you can physically see my little loop there for the row, row, row pod. And what's really cool about this is I can actually trace the pods as I'm going along. And let's actually put one more pod in.
Row your boat.
Let's put one more pod in here because we're doing so well in creating this song. Why stop halfway, right? And so when we have this working with both kids and adults, they end up doing a lot of playing with this.
Your boat row, your merrily, merrily, life is gently down the stream.
There we go. So now we're getting the whole song going here.
Row, 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 your boat gently.
So I can trace the pods as I'm going along, and I can tab over on my computer and actually hear the pods played back for the different order that they're in. And these are totally screen reader accessible. I'm just using tab and shift tab to move between controls on the computer.
Play row for one time speed and loop. Play your boat for one time speed. Play gently down the stream for one time speed.
And what that means by one time speed is I could actually increase the speed there, and it could be two times speed so that we could make all of this sort of a chipmunk sounding thing.
Gently down, life is but gently down the speed.
Now let's get our... There we go. And I did that just by changing the speed, and now it would say that this, if I hit the play and stop, it would say that the speed was two times. So again, I'm just learning the physical act of programming by plugging pods in and making different lines of programs. I have plugs that I can use for things like a pause or for an infinity loop so that I could make it sing row, row, row your boat until the exhibit's closed. I'll spare you that. How this works. The hub is being powered off of four AA batteries. The pods all get their power from the hub, and the hub is connected to the computer via Bluetooth. And so you can, if I can use this and become a coding genius, pretty much anyone can. So I'm holding out a lot of hope for Code Jumper. It's available for sale in late July, price point to be determined. And again, our website is www.codejumper.com, and you can keep up with all the latest happenings with Code Jumper. You can also call the American Printing House at 800-233-1839. You can email me at davewilkinson@aph.org.
So that's your tech tip for this week. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.